I'm Jenny. I've been painting for over 40 years and I use the wet into wet or alla prima method, and I want to share with you what I have learned. You can oil paint too, so let's have some fun.
Canvases don't always have to be white. They can be gray, like this canvas. I took a white canvas and painted it with an acrylic gray. You can use acrylic paint, you can use acrylic gesso. And then I'm just taking some Prussian blue, a little bit of Prussian blue, a little bit of white, tiny touch of black, because I want the sky to be kind of darker. Just kind of painting in some background areas here, different blues. There's a little bit of phthalo blue. I'm going to bring this right on down to my horizon. You notice that I have a horizon line. Make sure it's straight. I think it's a little crooked there. Make sure I've got a piece of tape there. I'm going to make this a seascape, so I'm going to put a piece of tape there, and that's kind of giving me the idea of where my horizon line is. It's going to keep it nice and straight for me. And I'm just various colors of blue, various blues. I'm leaving the center a little bit with no paint because I want my clouds in there. I'm going to make some nice billowy clouds. And I want them to be a little bit brighter. I'm going to pull this water on down right into this area down here a little bit. A little bit of blue. Just getting a little bit of color on there is all I'm doing. Not very much at all. And then I know that on down farther, a little bit of burnt umber. Very thin, so add a little medium to it. And get a little bit of that color down in here where I know I'm going to have beach. Just get a little bit of an underpainting going there. And when I remove my tape here, I'll have a little area there that I'll have to paint with some of that blue. So next I'm going to use a fan brush for my sky, for my clouds. You can use a larger brush, whatever works for you. I'm going to add a tiny, tiny, tiny touch of alizarin crimson into my paint here. Picking up mostly white. Lots of paint onto my brush, and I like to use the corner of my brush to get nice big fluffy clouds up here. Corner of my brush, you'll notice that I'm leaving some areas without color. It's going to pick up that nice gray that I've got going on behind there. And I'm thinking about the shape of clouds. Now, people have a tendency to go, you know, big circles and just make big balls of cotton up there. And we don't want to do that. We want to have some shape to our clouds, and I want to think of these clouds as being in layers. A little bit more pink, maybe. Let's add a tiny touch of yellow. Tiny touch of yellow to my white, and I mean really tiny. This just kind of brightens the white up a little bit. This is some variation. Up and down. Again, I'm thinking in terms of shapes of clouds, right? I'm kind of happy with it. And also get the shapes of clouds, get layers in there. See, I've got a layer up here at the top. This is a layer. Then down here, there's a layer. Down in here, there's another layer. Also, I'll notice that down here along the horizon, these might get smaller down in here. A little more loopier. You can play with clouds all day. They're fun. Picking up a little bit of that blue back in there. That's okay. That's a good thing. Maybe these clouds go right off the top up here a little bit. Big sky, big clouds. I'm going to wipe my fan brush off, and I'm going to go back to a smaller brush. And I'm going to use the smaller brush to just go in here and kind of blend away a little bit of the bottom of the cloud, of these cloud shapes. Just touching, softening. I could use a mop brush for this. That's a good idea. Let's grab a mop brush. Clean, dark, dry brush, mop brush. No paint on there. And I'm only using the very tip of the brush. And I'm just softening the bottoms. I don't want to mess with the tops. If I mess up my tops, I can go back and add more paint. But I'm really just softening those bottoms. That will push the cloud back into the landscape or into the sky a little bit and make these look more like clouds. Soften, soften, soften. The ones over here, we'll soften those a little bit more. See, as I soften them, that little bit of that gray is going to show through. Gives me some depth. Soften some of the brush strokes out of there. The softer you make them, the farther back they're going to appear. So keep that in mind. Wipe my mop brush off. If I want to go back, I can take a little bit more white. And if I want to sharpen up some of my edges up here, I can do that. Just picking up pretty good amounts of white. And redefining some of those edges, some of those parts that I want to be a little brighter. Just getting rid of brush strokes here, not trying to soften this color up too much. Just getting rid of a little bit of the brush stroke. Okay. I like that. Now, take off my tape. I can go back in here with my big brush, a little bit of the blue, pull that blue that I had down here, pull that up into the horizon line there. Soften right along that edge of my clouds there just a little bit. This I'm using phthalo blue for this. It's a little softer back in here. This is going to go behind my wave, so I'm going to go ahead and make sure I have a nice amount of the blue, phthalo blue right there, soften that edge. Just soften it because I want it to appear farther away, and go right in with my clouds, really softening that edge. Okay. Now, I'm going to set that brush aside. I'm going to grab a little filbert. I want to kind of draw in where I want my wave to be, and I know that, let's use, well, any one of these colors on here. Let's use a little bit of my blue and purple. Blue and alizarin crimson make purple, sorry. And let's decide right here is going to be the crest, the top of that wave right there. Maybe it comes down right here, has another little crest. Maybe right here is kind of like the part that comes over right there. So let's leave that in there. So the nice thing about drawing with your brushes that if you decide to change something, you can get it changed just by blending it away. So this is going to come over. This is going to come down. That's going to be kind of like this, the back of the wave. And I'm going to take, it's going to have another little area right here that kind of comes up there. And then it's just going to kind of disappear off into the distance there. Right? So that's kind of the basic. This is going to be the part that where the eye of the wave is. This is going to come down right here. Just kind of drawing in that shape. Okay. Kind of disappears. Okay. On this side, this is going to kind of go off into the distance here. Like that. Let's go ahead and, well, I've got this brush out, a little Prussian blue, a little bit of white. Let's add a little hint of waves back in here. Little scoopy smiley faces is what I like to call them, back in here, just to kind of give us the idea that that's what's going on back in there is waves. We can highlight those a little bit more later. Same thing here. Along that horizon can be a little lighter. Just looking at my clouds and thinking about the bottoms of some of these might need a little bit more blending away. Little darker areas might be good. You never have to be finished with anything. If you see something that needs adjusting, go ahead and adjust it. don't like something, change it. I didn't really like that area right there. Whoops. A little dark right in there, but that's all right. I'll just blend it right in. Go back up here and darken this corner a little bit more anyway. That gives that more of a contrast back here, which helps our cloud bank show up a little bit more. Again, I want this bottom right in here to blend away. Gives it a little bit more depth, I think. Okay. Okay, back to my little wave here. I know that the wave is going to kind of come down right here. Right in here is where the you know, it's going to tumble over right there. My eye is going to be right in here. And then it's just kind of go off. Now, I want to put some underpainting on this wave. I can do that quickly with a larger brush. Just take a little bit of dark right along the wave, darker blue, Prussian blue, maybe with a little bit of phthalo blue. Base of my wave. That way all my colors, my other colors will show up. My lighter colors will show up. Just kind of blend that in together. And I'm going to take a little bit of more of that burnt umber. Make sure I get that dark enough down in here. That's my sandy beach area. I'm going to use a little bit of phthalo green and phthalo blue together, and I'm going to indicate where that area of the wave that kind of comes down, turns over. I'm going to put that in there. A little bit of this can go underneath here. Nice to touch. Take a little bit of that. I'm going to take yellow and some of that phthalo green, and I'm going to put right here in my eye. Tiny touch of that along that, and then some of this will come out in this area too. Wipe my brush off, go back and get some straight yellow, maybe some yellow and white, get this nice and bright in here. I'm using a softer brush to kind of blend that, those colors together. This to be a little lighter along here. I just wanted to add some of this color up in the sky. I think it helps to make a more cohesive look. I'm going to pick up some more phthalo blue or phthalo green down in here to darken this edge just a little bit. Wipe my brush. yellowish right in there. I know that right along. Phthalo blue and alizarin crimson. I'm going to go along here and add a little bit of a, this is going to be the shadow of those, all that foam that we're going to put in here. Think about what's going on down here at the bottom of this wave right in here. It's nice and dark. Shadowy. It's going to be a little shadow right along the top there, and then it's going to kind of go right along here on the top of this wave area. There's going to be foam at the top of this area here. Very loose. But on the dark side, some of this is going to come up into this area. Think about the shape of these. I start off adding a little bit of foam. I'm using a filbert brush for this because I like how I can twist and turn. Push into that. Push into those other colors and get them blending. I'm going to take a little bit of white and get this right in here. Get that area that's going over. Get that in there. A little bit of white is going to blend right in with my colors that I already have on there. Don't overblend and keep your strokes going at an angle. That's the angle that that wave would crash. Back to my white here. Thicker paint. I'm just painting, and if I get something out of it, fine. If not, I don't worry about it. I'm taping this painting that I'm doing. It's kind of my version of a Bob Ross thing. Kind of flipping, letting my brush flip up a little bit here on the edges. Helps get that little bit of splash going on up here. Boop, boop, boop. And I make those sounds. Bit of splash maybe right here, right? going along here and adding little splashes, little highlights. I'm gonna let this fade off and not be so high, you know, have so many highlights over there. I can add a little bit of detail here. Just using the edge of my filbert. I can add some more details in here later with a liner brush as well. I'm going to take a smaller filbert, dry filbert, and I'm going to go right along the base of here and kind of blend the whites into the blues, into the darker shades, and little purples in there for more highlights. I just want to blend that just a tiny bit, soften it. You could probably use a smaller blender mop brush. If you had a tiny mop brush, you could use that right along the base of this too. Go back with a little more yellow and white right here in my center. I'm going to brighten that spot up just a touch more. Be a little too yellow. Darken this spot right here as it comes down. Remember that in order for lights to show up, you have to have dark next to it. And sometimes when we think our lights are not light enough, it's really a matter of getting the dark next to it. That's a little better. Just a touch of light. Coming through. I want the base here to be darker. And Prussian blue, add a little black to it and get this base a little darker. Put it in here. Okay, and then for some fun, we could take a small palette knife and we can add a little bit of foam . We start over here, very firm pressure. Kind of depends on which way you want your waves to connect back in here, as to which direction you can use this knife. And then I like to pull my waves, these back up in here a little bit. Bit of burnt sienna and yellow ochre. Add a little bit of that in there to kind of lighten my beach here and there. Bright, a little bit of dark. Use all your darks. Let's add a nice little bit of rocky formation right here. I'm just going to put some dark in here, a little black to my burnt umber. And a little rocky ledge right there. A little yellow ochre right across the top. Pull that down. The edges a little bit. Easel's kind of getting away of my edge right there, but that's all right. And what I'd like to do, let's get a little bit of yellow ochre and sap green. Right along the base of this guy. Or sap green. A little bit of brighter grasses there. You can kind of pull these up. Let's use our fan brush. Using sap green and cad yellow, and just letting the brush on my fan brush to just kind of create that little bit of grass going up. A little bit of a grassy knoll, and we can add some, let's add some palm trees into our picture here. I'm gonna pick up a filbert, and I'm gonna get burnt umber and black. And right in here, I'm just going to take my brush and right up into the sky here. A little thicker at the bottom, let up on the pressure as I go up. A little thicker on the pressure as I'm down here, and then lighten up on the pressure as I go up. Take that right on up there a little bit. I need to add a little bit of medium to my brush to get the paint to come off. That's a good thing. There we go. Maybe one more, right? The ground around these a little bit so they look like they're part of that area. I'll take a little bit of yellow ochre and white, give myself just a little bit of a highlight. Not too much. I don't want to get that, lose my dark there, so. So make sure to keep the base of your tree thicker than the top. Use my fan brush, and I'm going to start out with dark green. I'm going to take sap green and black in my paint so that it'll come off really easily. Sap green and black with a little bit of medium in there. I'm going to think about how this if my paint is not coming off my brush, I may have to add more medium. Wind is blowing, right? Okay, and I'm going to take... bit of my lighter green and kind of highlight the top edges a little bit. Don't want to lose my darks. If I lose my dark, which I think I did in that one, I'll go back and add it. Oops, too much light. Blend it away just a little bit. Okay, now I can take my liner brush. Medium to it, and I can go in here with some brighter brights to a little detailing. I can also go back in here and add in some dark. So these guys make more sense in terms of where they're connecting. That one to be behind this tree, so I'm going to put that in there. And then I'm going to take this trunk back over. That guy. Okay. Okay.